Hello, my name is Dr. Jeff Golini, and welcome to another episode of Ask the Scientist. This show is about busting myths and bringing you the truth. Hey, I got an email from Brian in California, and Brian says, Dr. Jeff, can you tell us how you went about discovering Kre-Alkalyn? Sure enough, Brian, I'm going to give you the story right now. You know, back in the early 90s, I was bored one day, and I decided to take all these different creatine products that we made, fruit flavored and effervescents, you name it, and start activating them with water. And I introduced them to my Brennan Luby near-infrared machine to see what would happen. And all of a sudden, I started to see high creatinine levels. So I thought, you know, machine must not be working right. So I redid that whole experiment and started over again. And lo and behold, again, high levels of creatinine. So I sent the same samples and instructions off to my good friend, Dr. Dinesh Patel at Atlas Bioscience, and asked him to kind of repeat the experiment. But this time use HPLC. And he came back to me and said, well, you know, it did convert to creatinine, but everybody knows creatine is not stable in solution. So I expected that. So then I got to thinking, well, geez, the fruit flavored drinks seem to have more creatinine than the water drinks. So I started to manipulate the pH of the solution to see what would happen as I lowered the pH. And as I lowered that pH, that conversion to creatinine was much, much quicker. Now remember, creatinine is a bio waste, a byproduct. You don't want to be ingesting that kind of stuff. So then I thought, well, let me see what happens if I start to alkalize this. And I slowly went up the pH range. And when I got to 14, I got that conversion to stop. So that night I went home and was praying about it, and the good Lord gave me a formula. I woke up the next morning, hurried off to the lab, and I started working on a way to synthesize creatine in an alkalized state to keep that conversion from ever happening. And sure enough, I was able to accomplish that and got my first U.S. patent. Was issued in 2001, was the patent pending. The patent issued right after that. Went on to get a few more patents overseas. And that's kind of the story of Kre-Alkalyn. You know, remember, Kre-Alkalyn is the only stable form of creatine. Does what it's supposed to do. Anyway, Brian, hope that answers your question. Hey, if you guys want to try Kre-Alkalyn, you know, don't take my word or any of the marketing. You know, give it a try for yourself. Down at the bottom of the screen, you'll see my email address. Just reference the show, ask the scientist, and say, hey, I want to try Kre-Alkalyn. I'll send you out some free samples at no charge. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you next time.